All right, Steve Darling back with Proactive Investors here at the LD Microcap in Beverly Hills, California. And Jeremy Frommer, the CEO of Jerrick Media Holdings, is with us. Good to see you again.
Good to see you.
Last time we were chit-chatting, we had a lot of things to say, and we'll get into a lot of what you had to say. But one of the things was you were talking about getting some partnerships with creators. And where are we at with that part?
I remember we were talking about the idea of the kind of accelerated growth we're seeing in our creator community.
Yeah.
Last time we were discussing this, literally a few months ago, we were hovering around 200,000 content creators.
Yeah.
Today, I think that number has broken through 250. Wow. At the current moment, I think we're adding almost 1,000 content creators a day. And really what's drawing them is the partnership opportunity to really have their voice heard within the appropriate communities we have for them, and hopefully monetize some of their content along the way.
And the one thing that we see in this world is content is king right now. Everybody's looking for it. And a lot of people have great content, but no way to get it out or get it somewhere.
Right. Content may be king, but without the distribution, you don't have much of a kingdom.
Absolutely. And that's what's very important. And I'll see what you're excelling at right now.
Right.
We recently published an article at Proactive, and there were some comments made about Google. And whether or not they're a monopoly or non-monopoly. Talk about your thoughts on Google and what they're up to.
I think the quote I said was that those people who think Google is a monopoly have sour grapes.
Yeah.
I really do maintain this disposition that there's been a significant leveling of the playing field in technology today. Mm-hmm. And continual reliance on the perception that Google, Facebook, and these companies have monopolies is not as much the case as is we are not taking advantage of what is in front of us as a world relative to the digital and the technology space.
Right.
You know, as far as we've come, you could look at a tremendous amount of corporate America today, and literally, they're still two decades behind the kind of conversations we're having today about my company.
Right. And that's an important part, because if you're in technology, you should be ahead of the curve. Wouldn't you say?
I think that if you're in technology, it's by very definition the fact that you're staying ahead of the curve. It is implicit in the ability to be in technology. I've often told people on this particular trip out here today that there's a level of hubris that existed in the technology space a while back. And that level of hubris was that we believed that at many levels, the tech that we had arrived at was the end of the process, the end of the evolutionary process. So for a great many years, whether it was WordPress or other giant publishing platforms out there, they took for granted this ever-growing audience that they had. And eventually, that model began to break. And the models that Google and these other giant companies that we were referring to, their models are beginning to break also. And it is the entrepreneurs that I meet at conventions like this that will create that disruption.
And are you finding that here at the conference, or the people that you met today? Are some interesting ideas out there?
Look, I have many, many views on the microcap space in particular. But I certainly think that each year that I come here, I see that the quality of the CEOs is improving, that the products are improving, that the CEOs are improving their businesses. A great deal of those are very cutting edge tech in both the biotech and the pure tech spaces. And I think the fabulous thing about a convention like this is that the giant VC community ignores the microcap space.
Right.
The institutional world ignores the microcap space. Yet the entrepreneurs in the microcap space are some of the most brilliant, hungry, hardworking people I've ever known. And they're just as deserving of the money that the big institutions are giving out to companies at, you know, exacerbated valuations that don't really produce any end results.
You mentioned CEOs are getting better. In what way? What makes a good CEO? Is it not moving too fast, moving too fast? What do you think makes a CEO a strong one in a company,
well,
a microcap?
Asking about like what makes a CEO strong, you're specifically asking me about what makes a CEO strong in the microcap space.
Absolutely.
What does it take to be that kind of person?
Absolutely.
I will tell you, for me, it takes a stomach of steel.
Stomach, very true.
That's my best advice, is stay in good physical shape, because it is some roller coaster of a ride, and you must have a stomach of steel.
Now, there's some talk that you're going to be going public soon.
Uplisting. Yes, so yes.
Tell us about that.
Well, we've been in discussions with a number of different groups, and we're finally picking one group that's going to take us through the next 12 months of our journey as a public company. That announcement will be coming soon. And that group will hopefully take us to the uplisting that I'm expecting in April of next year.
And what would that do for you?
Well, really, I think, you know, like any type of company joins the microcaps, you know, community, your ultimate intention is to raise more capital if you have a scalable business model. The capital markets exist so that entrepreneurs, and that's really the origin of it all, so that entrepreneurs would have the opportunity to leverage what are good, scalable, authentic products. True, that model has gotten bent out of shape over times, but still fundamentally, that's what it's all about. So, you know, at the end of the day, getting an uplisting will open up the type of doors to new types of investors, to new types of funding that will hopefully propel Jerrick to the next level that I foresee in our future.
Great to talk to you as always.
Thank
you very much.
Great talking to you too.
Look forward to our next visit. Jeremy Fromm, the CEO of Jerrick Media Holdings.
Thank you.